The desperate sailors are getting all the more desperate. And the night was not what they had hoped for.
Well, now it's morning again, and we've had a pretty good night. But we're not really well off here in this natural harbor. Wind comes in from our stern more than expected, so it's a little bit jerky. And it's 7 o'clock now, and we decided to go. It's gonna start rain also. So this is typical Sweden. This is how it is. Sometimes it's paradise, sometimes it's...
Joni and Martin are forced to take their escape.
It could have even have been dangerous to be there, because if the waves would have grown bigger, we might not have made it out from that natural harbor.
It often happens like this. The weather changed through the night.
Instead, they motor into a nearby harbor on the island of Dunsö.
You got it?
Yeah, I got it.
But it's only for a short rest. Soon their hoist their sails for another leg of the journey. But the weather still isn't on their side.
It's good wind today. Not much sail up, doing almost 7 knots.
With windy conditions, and now even rain. But when the sea is sour and the weather is foul, a chocolate bar can make the sun come out. At least in the minds of the sailors. Okay, break's over, back to reality. So just how rugged a sailor are you really?
Sailing in windy conditions or when it's a little rough, it's a great experience. Sailing is a sport.
Sailing can be wonderful, but when it rains and you're cold, and especially if you're getting hungry, it's...
Windy, rainy, rough, that's sailing.
What really helps when you're in that condition is something good to eat.
It's the common weather here. You have to like it or stay home. That's it.
Whatever the case, the journey continues. Now passing Gothenburg's northern archipelago.
But soon you will see a very beautiful sailing ships, old sailing ships.
Okay.
Very beautiful. Several of them. I don't know why they're here, but it's a pleasure for us to see them.
Ships that I saw, they were majestic, so good looking ships. I really would like to sail on the ship like that.
After passing this castle of Marstrand, the wind starts to abate and turns more northerly, which forces Joni and Martin to start tacking their way north. With the lighter winds in the wrong directions and sunlight diminishing by the minute, they will need to change their plans. Their goal, Alter Island, is beyond reach. Instead, they have to seek a safe haven elsewhere.
When we didn't reach Alter Island, I was a little bit disappointed because I really liked that place, and I had promised Joni also we would go there and I can show him the interesting history and the surroundings. But, you know, things happen when you sail.
It wasn't that important for me, actually. It would have been nice to see it, but any natural harbor could be as good as that. No problem. I'm not disappointed.
they search a sea map and find another good natural harbor, Sand Island. Yet again, things do not turn out the way the sailors wish.
When we got into that natural harbor, we said, let's go into that island. But when we approached, we actually ran aground a little bit. We came up with the keel into the mud, and we couldn't continue any further. So we had to go out again and attach the boat to that buoy.
It's gonna be very windy tonight. Extremely windy, and but we feel safe here. But now, we'll see what Joni is doing. Let's go see what happens under deck.
Oh, we're back in the boat now. Here under deck we have the Swedish chef again. What are you up to?
Well, after a long day on the sea, we're tired, a bit cold, I will make some typical boat food.
Boat food, okay.
Yeah, oh. Very simple.
Typical boat food, I don't know what he means with that. You know, Joni, he has his own ideas sometimes, and yeah, it's exciting to see what would come up here. Mm.
So I make a risotto with a salmon.
I think to eat fish when you're out on a boat, that's common natural to me. So I thought that the salmon would be a nice dish with risotto.
And here's a little vitamin. Is it a C vitamin, Joni?
Sorry?
Is it C vitamin?
Yes, it's a C vitamin. It's very... in Swedish we call it skörbjugg.
Yeah, it's scurvy. It.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's just avoid scurvy.
Yeah.
Yeah, great. Thank you very much. Because I really felt it's coming.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But be careful, it's strong.
Oh, okay, good.
Strong C vitamin.
Okay.
In Sweden we call it schalottenlök.
Ah.
I don't know what you call it in English.
Charlatan onion.
Correct. Oh,
probably not.
Very good translation.
Yeah.
A little more mild taste. It's not that strong as common onions. So it's often used, for example, in risotto.
I am so sad. Now I'm boiling some water for chicken bouillon.
I think broth, chicken broth. Oh. Okie dokie, so what is this guy created?
Yeah, the typical boat food that you mentioned before. Yeah. Risotto, salmon, pepper salmon, simple.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's a little al dente, creamy, and it's really good. Some white wine too.
White wine?
Yep.
Mm. Mm. I'm hungry. Let's eat.
Yeah.
The food was excellent.
Mm.
Really good.
Ooh.
Thank you, Joni. How do you feel?
I'm so glad. And the salmon, not overcooked.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect.
The risotto that Joni did was wonderful. That was a real meal. That was not just like leftovers the day before. So that was a nice surprise.
It's not that easy, you know, to cook down in a kitchen like that, but you can do anything, I promise.
I had no fears about cooking on Martin's boat except an explosion from the gas fumes or something, but to be honest, I'm used to cook in a smaller kitchen than this.
Great, thank you very much.
The desperate sailors are safe and sound, but not for long. Don't miss the next episode.
Who is steering
the boat?
Ah, nobody. Put the sails out.
They call it the devil's hole.
I am a rock.
7 knots. And don't miss our next episode.
Don't miss next episode.
I just said that.